Space, we're leaving Mother Earth to save the human race. Our star blazers, a cry for help, a desperate plight makes our star force reunite as we rush to meet our fate. The comet empire awaits. We must be strong and brave to stop its evil ways. If Zordar's plot should work, he'll destroy the universe. We'll fight the Comet Empire, battle through the raging fire, filled with the hope that Earth will survive. We'll keep peace alive with our star blazers.
In the early 23rd century, a dreadful space war erupted in the galactic nebula. The Galman Empire, the most powerful and aggressive in the universe, unleashed its forces to conquer the entire galaxy. During the battle, a gigantic proton missile went astray. It plunged into the sun. The missile exploded on impact, causing a vast nuclear fusion reaction. It was believed that within 1 year, this reaction would cause the end of all living things on Earth. There was no other choice for mankind but to find another planet Earth and to emigrate there. The rebuilt space cruiser Argo was given the mission to search for that new planet. Southern Island, a peaceful resort in the South Pacific. Orders to report for duty on the Argo reached even this tiny island. And the Argo's communications officer, Homer Glitchman, hurriedly packed to leave.
Oh. Can I help you, miss?
Little bird, I wanted to bury it somewhere, but I couldn't find any soil.
There's nothing but pavement around here. Ah, maybe out by the runway. Come on.
Flight 92 for Guam, Hawaii, and Vancouver. Now departing from gate 6. All aboard, please.
Oh, look, a wild chamomile. Here. It's a present from a little bird. Its spirit is saying thank you. Well, goodbye and good luck.
Didn't ask her name or where she lives.
The work in the computer room is behind schedule. Let's get cracking. Come on, man. My new robot crew and I can do all the brain work. Just because nobody believes us, all those fancy computers had to be put on board, and I say it's unfair competition.
Listen, IQ-9, we didn't put those computers on board just to get you jealous. The ship will need them. Who knows what we'll meet out there?
Is that so?
Sure is.
I'm not worried.
So you're not feeling very well.
I keep thinking about her. It makes it hard for me to do any work.
While preparations are underway to send the Argo on its most important mission, there is a violent battle far out in space as the Galman Empire attacks the planet Birth.
Open fire!
Evade the attackers. Try warping.
Oh, the defenders have warped. All attack forces go into a warp. Follow and destroy.
It's one of the attackers! Quick, fire!
We're heading for some planet.
It doesn't matter, because eventually all of the planets in this solar system will belong to the Galman Empire. Let's enter their atmosphere and look about.
Emergency alert. Emergency alert. Emergency alert. Emergency alert.
Unidentified spaceship entering Earth's atmosphere. Could be a warship. General, that ship is heading for the Canadian Rockies.
Notify the Argo right away.
Yes, sir.
Commander Wildstar, an urgent message. It's from headquarters.
Okay, patch me in on the video screen.
Right.
Wildstar, you've been alerted that an unidentified spaceship is nearing your base in the Canadian Rockies.
Yes, General, but we don't plan to reveal the presence of our base here unless there's trouble.
The unidentified ship seems to be looking for a landing spot in the Canadian Rockies. All of mankind is depending on the Argo finding a new Earth, so nothing must interfere with your mission. Avoid all action, but if that ship finds the Argo and attacks, you'll have no choice.
Yes, sir.
Unidentified ship approaching at 23,000 feet, 4 miles west of the Canadian Rockies. Squadron Leader Conroy, take your Cosmo Tigers and intercept.
On the way.
The sentinels on the ground approaching, sir.
Wait till they get into our range and then hit them.
Unidentified spaceship dead ahead. Group 7 and 8, make your attack from above. The rest of you Cosmo Tigers, follow me. Okay, begin attack. Break off the attack. That's it. We've done it, Tigers.
Hey.
Company, turn up!
Tomorrow morning, at exactly 5:30, the Argo is going to launch on a mission to save mankind. As many of you already know, our mission is to find somewhere in space a planet just like our own Earth. Our journey into the unknown will not be an easy one. Out there, somewhere, tremendous battles are being waged, and our entire solar system is in danger because of that war. This was brought home to us by our recent electronic problems. At any rate, there is no guarantee that we will return safely or even survive. If any of you have changed your minds about going, you may leave the ship now. You, Homer? Do you wish to leave the ship?
Homer, you? You who fought with us on all those other missions?
Forgive me, Derek. Forgive me, everyone.
Why, Nova?
It's simple as a man falling in love. He doesn't know who the girl is, but he has to find her. And he knows that if he doesn't, within a year, it'll be too late.
A year is so little time. Will we fail?
Derek, what is it?
Nova, do you really think we'll be able to find another Earth within just 1 year? Mark Venture sounds so optimistic when he says that there should be at least one or two planets like Earth out there among those countless stars. But what if we can't find another Earth? What future can there be for the people of this Earth if we fail to find a suitable planet to which they can emigrate? What happens if the Argo gets caught up in that space war out there? What if the Argo is crippled in that war? Worrying about all this, I can't sleep at night. Sometimes I wish I could leave this ship.
Oh, Derek!
What a forsaken place from which to leave to save mankind. My granddaughter, Wendy Singleton, I've told her so much about the Argo, she wanted to see it for herself. Members of the Argo, I am the commanding general of Earth's defense forces, and I am the man responsible for sending all of you out into space. The Earth federal government has finally agreed to restudy what is happening on the sun, but they will not acknowledge that it is dangerous to Earth. Therefore, I personally have taken the responsibility of sending you on this important mission. Officially, you are being dispatched to patrol the peripheral areas of our solar system, and so there is no one but my granddaughter and me to send you off. I believe that you and the Argo will succeed and bring back news of a new planet Earth. To a successful mission and a safe return, success!
Success!
This is the command bridge. I only use my command chair when we're launching or landing or there's some kind of emergency. Most of the navigational equipment and computer controls are right here. Oh, that reminds me. General, our communications officer left.
For what reason, Commander?
On Southern Island, he met a young lady, and he fell in love with her there. He didn't know her name, but he went to find her and to...
He met her at the airport on Southern Island?
The young lady was there, aboard the Argo. Commander Wildstar ordered an immediate search for his communications officer.
Bring him back immediately.
Yes, Commander.
Homer, you're still on board. I thought you'd left the ship.
I did, Skipper. But then I realized that finding a new planet Earth was more important than looking for one girl, no matter how much I was in love with her. And miss her.
Homer, come with me. I want you to meet someone.
Meet someone, sir?
I did it, George. Yes. Thank you. Oh, yes, I did.
Hey, Homer, why don't you ask her name?
I'm Wendy Singleton.
And I'm Homer Glitchman.
Very well done, Homer.
Good luck, Commander.
I'll see you again.
Goodbye.
Not goodbye. We'll be together someday.
Homer, I have a hunch we'll make it. It's time, Nova.
Yes.
This is your commander. All hands prepare for launch. All hands prepare for launch. Preparations completed. The Argo is ready.
Main thruster start!
Power building, main thruster.
Release closing valves of main cylinder.
Main cylinder valves opening up.
Cylinder pressure of wave engine increasing.
Okay, 5 seconds to thruster ignition on my count. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Contact and ignition.
Okay, Mark. Break free.
Here we go, Skipper. This is it. Full power.
Thank you.
We salute you, planet Earth.
Before blastoff, Homer never had the chance to tell the girl he met on that island in the South Pacific that he loved her. It would have to wait until his return. The increase of fusion on the sun meant the ultimate destruction of its solar system. Where could mankind go? There were only 329 days left. Less than 1 year.
Give up hope. If we can win, the earth will survive. We'll keep peace alive with